We're here at the Love and Spencer Flow sponsored GEMS clinics for young ladies between the age of 10 to 17. We have participants from Monrepo, Grosile, Barbono area, and some people from Castries. And what we've done, we started off with basic drills, introducing them to basic drills for high jump. We separated them so far in two groups, the younger group and a more senior group. We have assistance from four other coaches. We have Gregory Lubin, Philip Anthony, Nakiba Alse. Also, the clinic is directed by Coach Benetella Sporis, and we also have assistance from Mr. Wayne Benty. The participants are quite happy. Luvan has graced us with her presence and given her input.
I just want to thank you all for being here. Without you all, the clinic would not have been possible. You know, I want to thank the coaches and the PE teachers for being here as well. I'm grateful and thankful for you all turning out. I hope that whatever has been done today, that you actually learned something from it. Especially the young ones, I'm happy that you turn out, because for me, I started when I was in secondary school, and she's in form two, and I started when I was your age in form two, which I think was, you know, pretty late. If I had the opportunity, I would start, you know, at your level in primary school, because if you watch the swimmers and tennis players at age 7, 8, 9, they're already swimming or playing tennis. So, at your level, I'm happy that you turned out to actually learn about the event. Also, for the secondary school kids, I know it's not too late. I started when I was in form two, like I said, and now I'm a professional athlete. I've been looking around and see what's going on, and it seems like it's a lot. And you cannot learn everything about high jump in one day. It takes a lot of practice and it takes a lot of time. I know some people were saying, you know, it's too hard and they can't learn it. There's no way you can learn everything in this clinic. So what I'm trying to say is that it's a start, and I'm happy that you all are here to learn the basics. And whatever you all learn here today, that it's not going to stop after today, it's just the first day. So you'll have to go back and keep working at it, keep practicing. Don't come to practice only when you all know that there's a competition coming up. It doesn't happen like that. Even if you're talented, it takes a lot of hard work as well. Because I am talented, but I work very hard to become, you know, the best I can be as a professional athlete. A lot of times people think like you just have the talent, and when the competition is coming up, you just want to come and represent their house and win. But if you want to be the best you can be, you have to work hard at anything you want to do in life. And also, you know, while everyone was doing the different activities, you know, I just watched, you know, body languages and everything like that. So I want to let you know that it's important to be, you know, disciplined and listen to your coaches, because these are not your coaches, but they were your instructors at the time. And many times, you know, you run and you say, oh, I can't do this, or it looks really hard, but you don't know until you try. Because when I just started, for those of you who don't know, Mr. Lubin was my first high jump coach, and he's the one that was helping you right there, the one with the shades at the back. He was the one who started. He's the one who told me, you know, just do the high jump for your house. And I had no idea how to do high jump. I didn't know the technique. I didn't have the form. But if I had said no to him, I would have never been, you know, a high jumper today, or I'd never been a professional high jumper. So I'm just saying that to say, sometimes you never know what you can become in life, but whatever you do, you know, you take it seriously and you work hard at it and just give it a try, and you might like it. Maybe the first time you do it, you might not win or you don't like it, but you know, if you keep working hard at it, then you too can be successful. So, you know, thanks again to the coach. I hope that, you know, you all had fun, you all learned something, and you all continue to put into practice. And I wish everyone all the best here. But like I said before, I'm happy that Flo came along to, you know, put on this clinic with me. And whenever I'm back on island in St. Lucia, whether it's a short break, it's always my desire to give back to students, whether it's athletes or not. You know, I love inspiring kids and helping young athletes, you know, pursue their dreams. Many times people ask me for my success and my longevity in the sport. And sometimes people just doesn't know how to balance everything, sports and school and everything. And when they hear it from someone who has been through that step or that process, then it makes a little more sense. So hopefully that, you know, is something that can be annual, and every year hopefully I can see y'all as well. I don't want to see y'all here for the first time and then next year we have this clinic and I was like, oh, where is, I don't know, what's your name? Yeah. Where is Afia? And Afia, you know, Afia is done with it. So hopefully y'all guys can continue, and all the best in your inter-secondary school sports, inter-primary school sports. Hopefully if I'm here, I come and support and see. And for those of you all have competed with at nationals, I know you all have the talent and the ability, because I saw you all at nationals, and you know, it's, the future looks bright with you all. And if you just continue to work hard at it and get the right technique, I think you too can be a successful or a professional athlete in the future in your own right. You know, everybody wants to be the next Love and Spencer, but you have to be more than Love and Spencer. In order to beat me, you have to be more than me. You can't just say, I want to be Love and Spencer or like Love and Spencer. To break my record, you have to jump higher than me. So it takes a lot of hard work. If you want to break that, you've got to work really hard and every day and be disciplined. So all the best. Keep working hard. And thank you all for being here. And I really appreciate you're all taking your time out to come here, because you could have been anywhere. You could have been sleeping at home. You could have been, I don't know, at the gym. So I'm grateful and thankful for, once again, Flo putting this, and you all coming here, and the coaches as well. So thanks again.
What we normally call the seizures, your neck, up and down.
I will demonstrate on the right, and I'll demonstrate on the left. So remember, I said the leg closer to the mat moves up first. Right, so we go. Right, both legs are straight, right? On this side. So for you on this side, legs over to the mat. On that side, legs over to the mat. You got that? For you on the mat. Let's go to the mat. On this side, you can have a direction for the foot. And I did. Everybody have to check. Let's go.
Wow. Use your hand. Now look in front of you guys, don't look down. Always look in front.
Emphasis in the kick and land sitting from the queen. It's important to land sitting. Your next drill depends on you sitting. Let's go. One more on this side, everybody. Let's go. Both of you do it twice because everybody has to go twice. First time you do that before? Let's go. Everybody go twice. No. I still want to see the leg movement. Still want to see the scissors, but that leg turns. Okay? Don't think of you flopping, you're not ready for that. Even if you could do it, don't think of you. Let's do the drill. Let's go. Put effort and keep that leg straight up for me. Let's go. Put effort in keeping that leg up. It's important. Remember all what we learned, you're sitting straight. No, Michael. Remember, scissors, or you are not in the beginning. You still don't have scissors. Let's go. Everybody, go try. Close to in one slot, so most of them will end up maybe around here. on that side around there, which will be your ticket. So guarantee, once you hit that mark, no matter what you do before, a jump or whatever, your last five strikes, once you start at that point, you take it to the exact point. So Mr. Anthony and I, we place your price at the 4 meter distance, where you're going to be the high jump bar. So what you're going to do now, we're going to, from the upright to here, we're going to mark 2 meters, and we're going to put distances up there, 4.5 meters, 5 meters, 5.5, 6, and 6.5. So this will be my 2 meter mark. So I'm putting a 4 meter marker in white. 4.5 in green. 5 meters in blue. 5.5 in white. 6 in green. 6.5 in blue. You can pull it up or down. Keep it straight because you're holding the chalk and you're going down with an arch to the bar. 6.5. Put the, 6 meters, we're doing the same thing for the 6 meters. Go square. Yeah, keep it straight and go down, yeah. Oh,
we're doing 5.5. Put your hand up, hold on. Yeah, okay, Matt. Starting up on that side, your first try will be of your jumping leg, which is your left leg. If you follow the markers right there, whatever line you are, once you follow it, you're on the inside of it, your last try should end up somewhere else. I'm going to go to the next one.
13 and a half, for me 20, 13 and a half. I remember those numbers. These maps. Let's go, interest of time. That's right, you can, that means you're telling me you're trying to kick your butt. Yeah, don't mind you kicking the mat, that's okay. Has everybody gone? Has everybody gone? Okay.
We'll never think we're going up not because of so you have to be safe. Let's go. Beautiful. Finally swing. Next.
The clinic is a very lively clinic. The participants are happy so far in what they have learned. So far, I have been dealing with the senior group, and we on our last phase, which is in teaching and introducing most of them to the Flossberry flop, which is the most used technique in high jump from recent times. We also have some participants who could have flopped before, but it was not done up to standard, so they happy for the new information that they've learned. Some of the coaches came by, they participated. I also taught them the technical way in marking the approach run up, and it seems to be going well for now.
Who believe they're ready to flop? Okay. Starting off your mark. Remember when you're hitting air? Listen. Remember I tell you, a lot of concentration, technical. So remember you're going off your five, you will hit air, and you all will hit air. Right? And remember, you all will hit air, right? And using that. All right. What did I just say? Right. So if you don't listen, you will go and hurt yourself. So now you were doing this and landing soup, right? What do you believe coming next? So now instead of you landing sitting down, so you will be landing on your back flopping. I do not look. Do not go too hard. Do not jump to the spike. You on a silver scooter slipper. I will be demonstrating, showing you what I expect from you. Alright? So the same thing people apply. You come, you hit, do that, and go. Alright? So we'll be doing it off our five steps. So we'll be going nice and slow. We will not be rushing. Concentrate. Count. No. Alright. No hustle. But you were doing it a while ago and you were doing that. So that's it, right? So here's what you're doing. Concentrate on what you're doing. Nice and easy. I want to hear you speak to yourself, tell yourself. So from time you go in out there, you come just take. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up, turn, land. So you tell yourself that. Because that's what you're doing. So I want to hear. Okay, she did a lot of things wrong. She had the five steps right. What she did? She flew over. She just took herself and she flew over the rope. She did not concentrate on going up, bringing that across and jumping. Critical. Not because the bungee cord is low, you just want to try and work. Effort in going up. The five steps, perfect, I give you that. But when you water, you just fly over the bar. Remember, when you're going up, you're going to have to for the next. Not too bad, beautiful. Somebody come. Not too bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Boom, up, over. Next. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now. Yeah.
Today we had the first ever Flo Laverne Spencer High Jump Clinic. It's been a long time coming because we've been involved with Laverne for quite a while, obviously through two Olympics now, through the St. Lucia's best ever Olympic finish. This year, very successful year for her, Commonwealth gold, NACAC gold, CAC, her third consecutive gold, and a medal as well at the Continental Cup. But what we wanted to do was to try to inspire the next generation of Laverne Spencers, the next generation of great athletes out of St. Lucia. We've been involved, aside from our collaboration with Laverne, we've been involved with athletics throughout the Caribbean, sponsoring a number of great athletes, but also sponsoring the Floca Rifter Games for the past few years. And we would love to be able to see some of these young ladies go on to the Carifta stage, not just compete at the Carifta stage, but perhaps get medals and records on the Carifta stage as well. And certainly we would love to see them emulate Laverne long term. And it's wonderful that she was able to give up her time, come and really inspire these young ladies, because they are truly inspired when they get to meet somebody that they've seen on TV, somebody that they truly idolize, and they're able to see and hear from her about her journey and try to put it into action in their own athletics endeavors.
I felt great having this experience here, especially with Laverne Spencer, one of the greatest high jumpers in St. Lucia, well, in the world. Having this experience here pushed me to see that I can do greater and I can be above the rest and not like down. I could be a leader, not a follower. I wish that I could be like Laverne Spencer. Having her speak to us here today, it motivated me to do the best that I can.
My experience was one of a kind, having Laverne Spencer here with me. Having Laverne Spencer here with me today was very awesome. It was great. It was nice to get to know some of our greatest and one of our greatest athletes. So I really like that.
Well, learning something new was something, you know, that I had to stop gliding over the bar because I don't flop, I scissors. So when they told me that, you know, I'm just gliding over the bar because I'm tall, I was like, for real? I didn't realize that I was doing something wrong, but now taking a look at it and seeing where I went wrong, it was really a good experience for me. So what was your experience for today?
I find that it was very informative and it helped me a lot. I will try to put what I learned here into practice.
Well, for me, I learned how to mark my run-up, so I have a better run-up now.
I find that today was a wonderful experience, and I just hope that I'll continue to, you know, do what I learned today.
Okay, so what are the things that you realized that you were doing wrong as a high jumper?
My run-up was wrong, and my turn was a bit off. I tried to work on it today.
My turn was off. Instead of flopping, I was more gliding over the bar.
My run-up was off. The way that I flopped was off. Yes.
All right. So working with one of our greatest, Laverne Spencer, could you tell me what was the experience for you guys?
It was a good experience, and I learned a lot from her past experience as a youth. And it just encouraged me, you know, to do better.
Okay, well, I learned that even though all of us started late, as we are in already secondary school, it doesn't mean that we can't learn as much or all of what we are supposed to know for high jump, so we still have hope.
Just inspired me to work harder and to continue at what I do and to basically renewed my motivation.
Okay, so right now, for everyone who is watching you guys here, could you give some of the children some inspiration for doing high jump or athletics in general?
I just want to say that it's never too late and that just keep working at what you do and you will see your goals and achieve your goals.
I would just like to say keep motivated. Even though you fail, everyone fails, just keep doing what you love.
All I have to say is pray hard, work hard, play hard.
I think this clinic went very, very well. Our numbers were not what we expected because of the rain. A number of persons couldn't make it because of the rain. But the idea that we got the primary school students out, this is a good place for them to start, you know, the high jump event. To get them exposed to the event at that age is very important. Even when Laverne spoke to them, she said she did not get a start until she was at secondary school. We don't have high jump at the primary school level right now, but hopefully that will change. And just the experience for those students to be with Laverne Spencer, that alone in itself is something to motivate them to not just be Laverne Spencer, but to be better than Laverne Spencer. So based on what I saw here today, based on the feedback from the athletes, from the coaches, I think it was a very successful clinic. Well, this is a start. This is just one clinic. So we need to have other clinics such as this, where we engage both the athletes, the coaches, the PE teachers, even the parents, because it takes a whole community to get to develop a champion. Champions are not just made on their own, just themselves and the coaches. So we have to engage other stakeholders, make people see the importance of athletics and what it takes to be a champion. So, I mean, we did some talent ID here at this clinic today, so now it's a matter of reaching out to those students that we identified, reaching out to their PE teachers and their coaches, and making other opportunities for them to be engaged and to get some technical assistance with the event. Everybody's a partner. We cannot do this without the parents. It starts with the parents, you know, doing what they can to motivate the athletes, giving them the resources that they need to get engaged in the sport, showing the interest, the parents themselves showing interest in sports. You cannot take out the school, the principals, the PE teachers, the coaches at the various schools, that's important. The neighbors in the community, growing up as an athlete myself, just the support I got from the community was something that helped me going. That kept me going. The business places are important in terms of providing the resources that are necessary for those persons, the national associations from the different sports, the Olympic Committee. I mean, everybody is involved. Everybody can be a stakeholder. Education is always a good thing. Sometimes we take it for granted. We say people know, or they should know this and they should know that, and sometimes they don't know. So sometimes we don't reach out to them because we say they're not showing interest. But we have to reach out to them and say, hey, this is the way that you can help. And we have to show appreciation when they help. Sometimes persons go out of their way, they give, whether it's their time, you know, money, whatever resources that they have, and they don't get even a thank you. So we have to show appreciation for persons who do contribute, and then we have to go out and ask persons to contribute and not just take it for granted that they know that they should contribute and whatnot, but we also have to make the effort. And we have to show progress, you know. Persons are more likely to support things where they see results. So we have to make sure that there are results, and persons are more likely to support something that is successful. Yeah, the clinic, I think, went very well. I'd like to thank Flo, first of all, for putting it on, Laverne for showing up, the teachers and coaches who showed up with the athletes themselves who showed up, the facilitators of the clinic. I'd also like to thank the Vidbutai Secondary School, the principal, and the Mopo Athletic Center for allowing us to use this jump center for the event and allowing us to use the equipment. They were very happy to allow us to use this facility, and so I'd just like to thank them for that.